Hi.
How was work?
It's good. Good.
It's good. Took a long day.
Mm-hmm.
That sucks.
Do we have any aspirin?
Yeah, we do. Do you want some?
Mm-hmm. Please.
Headache?
Uh-huh.
Thank you. Having me doing laps all day. You can stay in post rest if you want.
I'll come up.
Are you okay? Did you pull your back or something?
Must have. Finding bruises and cuts in the most random places. I have no idea where they're coming from.
That's weird. Can I look?
No. It's fine. It's just an ache.
Alright, well, don't go complaining about it in the morning. Can make you see some very unpleasant things. The clock's ticking.
I didn't want to wake you.
That's fine. You slept like a log. Like someone else I know. No.
What gives?
I don't want to smell like a cigar. That's such a crime.
No. I got a text from Rich. I have to take some people to the airport this morning.
Well, how long are we going to be gone?
I don't know. There's probably going to be traffic, so I can't give you a time.
Okay, it's fine.
I'll call you when I get a chance.
Right, I'll be here.
Fine, how are you?
Okay. Here you go.
How are you?
I'm fine. We're both fine.
You don't have to lie to your Uncle Raymond.
Okay. I just feel like... what's the phrase? Like I have cabin fever.
You can surely go out, can't you?
I mean, I can, but I haven't been out with the girl since Anna was born, and Michael and I have been craving time together.
Well, won't Michael watch the baby if you go out with your friends?
He'd love to, but he's always on call. I know he's just trying to bring back as much money as he can, but...
Well, you know, I'd be more than glad to step in if you need any help.
I really appreciate that. She's just not a fan of anyone that isn't Michael or myself.
Well, she seems to be acting, happy with me now.
Actually, I guess you're right.
Hello? Hey, honey, everything's great. What's up?
Everything's good here. I'm just with my uncle, and he says that if we want, he can watch Anna and we can go out on the town.
Anna okay with that?
Yeah, she's fine. She's laughing, enjoying his company.
Okay, well, that's a bonus. Okay, great. We'll head out tonight then.
Okay, cool. I'll pick something up.
I'm actually on my way to get 4 more people for the airport, and then Rich had to call it a day.
All right, yeah, sounds good. So I'll see you soon?
Maybe an hour and a half.
Okay, cool. I'll see you then.
All right, bye, hon.
Bye.
We might just have to take you up on your offer.
Hey, I'm more than happy to help.
Hey, Mike, wake up!
Oh, Jesus.
You almost gave me a heart attack.
How long was I out?
You pulled in 5-10 minutes ago.
I feel faint.
Jesus, you're soaked.
I need to go home.
I can give you a ride. You leave your car here, I'll bring you in tomorrow. Oh. You need to go to the hospital.
Just take me home.
All right. Hardly said a word this whole trip.
My mind's just been occupied is all.
I'm not gonna lie, Mike. You haven't been yourself lately.
Tell me about it.
Alright. Let's just say, I'm not your boss anymore. Let's just say it's you and me back in high school. What's up? There we go.
Richard, I would tell you if I knew.
Okay, well, now I am your boss. Will you be into work tomorrow? If not, I'll find someone to cover you.
Of course. We can't afford not to. With just not working, this is the only income we have.
Okay. Well, let me know if you want to meet up later at the bar. I need a drink.
Sure. What's the occasion?
For tonight. We're going out. You said earlier. Don't you remember?
Oh, that's right. I forgot. I'm sorry, but I really don't feel like heading out anywhere tonight.
Please tell me you're joking. We need this. What's the matter with you?
I think I'm coming down. Leave the dress out. Go text Kim, text all the girls, and go out and let your hair down.
No, it's fine.
No, it's not fine. I'll watch Anna. You deserve to get out of the house and breathe. Go. I'm not asking you.
Thanks, Mike. I really appreciate it.
Another day, but not tonight.
Fine. I'll text them.
Hi.
Wow. You look beautiful. You ladies have a great night.
You too. Bye.
Bye.
Love you.
Bye, Anna.
Have fun tonight.
Showing weakness, and he likes that.
What are you talking about?
He's getting closer.
Who is?
David.
What happened?
What happened? The neighbor tried knocking on the door because Anna was crying, and it didn't sound like anybody was here. I tried to call you twice.
My phone's on silent.
I tried the house phone, Michael. The monitor is right on the table. What's the matter with you?
It's nothing. I must have just gone into a deep sleep.
Knocked yourself out with a couple of pills, right?
No,
right.
It's nothing like that. I don't know.
I don't ask for a lot. Just one night. Kim told me that Richard found you sleeping in your car. What's up with that?
I felt faint and I...
Behind the wheel? Fuck! Michael, how do you expect me not to worry now?
It was in the depot. It's fine.
Today, it was in the depot. But the next time you choose to feel faint, it could be in the highway or on the railroad track.
It's not like that, Jess. I'm fine. I'm sorry I ruined your night.
It's fine. I assume you'll be up all night?
Why?
Clearly, you've already caught up on your sleep.
Were the girls pissed that you had to leave?
No, they understood. Don't forget, some of them don't have husbands or boyfriends and believe that all men are incapable of the simplest of things.
Do they ever wonder why they're single?
I'm worried, Michael. What's going on with you?
I'm all right.
No, you're not. All of these things are going through my head. Like, do you suffer from narcolepsy or something?
No, nothing like that. I've been having this recurring dream, but it's not.
And what's it about?
You're in it. But it's not you. It's something masquerading as you. I don't know. Your eyes are so dead. The black liquid, the noises. A clock is in a field, and every time the pendulum swings left and right, digs a grave. Like my time is running out. It's strange.
I'm gonna get some water. Do you want some?
Sure.
Hello? Hi, I'm sorry to disturb you so late, but I need to make an appointment.
Morning.
Morning.
Going somewhere?
Yes, with you.
Where are we going?
Okay, before I tell you, I need you to know I did this because I'm concerned.
Oh, what?
I made an appointment with a psychiatrist. His name's Dr. Levenstein. It's about your dreams.
Jess, I don't know.
You need to talk to a professional about this.
I'm not going to get my head examined.
You can start whenever you're comfortable.
I've never done anything like this before, so I'm finding it hard to word it all.
It's usually something that starts at the back of the mind that triggers sleep. Why not start at the beginning?
I can't tell you anything about my mom and dad because I didn't know them. I'm adopted. I have a brother, but he's been in a sanitarium for most of his life. I'm not allowed to see him.
Why is that?
He tried burning our house down with only myself inside. Officials say that if he was to see me, he'd try and kill me.
Does that bother you? That you can't see your own flesh and blood?
Why does it bother me? He's nuts. He tried to kill me.
Did you ever think it would be helpful to perhaps ask him why he resents you?
He's told me plenty of times. He blames me for our parents giving us up for adoption. They say there's an evil twin. There's evil, and then there's him.
He's your twin?
Yeah.
Hey, what happened?
I told him the same thing I told you this morning.
Which is... what? Did he prescribe you medication? Did he call you crazy? Are you safe to work? What happened?
We just talked.
We're a family, Michael. We don't keep secrets. What happens to you happens to us.
I know.
It doesn't seem like you do.
I'm not saying what happened to them, because nothing happened to them.
Hey guys, how'd everything go?
Your guess is as good as mine. What's up?
Kim said she had some books that I had to pick up.
I'll go get them.
Okay. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
No, you're not. I can tell. Here, let me see Anna.
It's just that things haven't been right for a while, and... he's just been so standoffish since Anna was born, you know?
There hasn't been a change in him at work or anything strange. Well, not since yesterday. Don't worry, though. I think I got a good offer for him.
What, another driving job?
School prom's right around the corner. They've asked us to drive him.
I don't even think he would be capable of that with all his blackouts.
He told me he's fine.
Well, he hasn't told me anything. He hasn't told me a fucking thing. What if it's an early sign of a tumor? I didn't even think of that. Oh my god.
Jess, don't beat yourself up about it. Besides, he's always been a drama queen. You get yourself worked up, turns out it's nothing, then you look the fool.
Yeah. Where is he? He probably doesn't even know where they are. Richard, he's collapsed! Michael?
I'll get some water.
Richard, oh my god, he did. Michael! Soon, Michael. Soon.
What is? Answer me! Who are you? You're not my wife, you're not Jessica! Who are you?
My name's Jessica Langham. I used to be Jessica Elston. Then I met Michael Langham. I'm mother to Anna Langham, and I used to...
Shut up! Shut up!
Sir, you need to stay calm.
Stay calm? I'm fine.
He's in shock.
No, I'm not. I feel fine.
We're going to have to take you to the hospital. You need to be looked at.
Listen, I've got more people looking at me than I need right now.
Sir, you need to come to the hospital with us.
Michael, go. Richard, can you take Anna?
Yeah, sure, no problem.
Hi, Jessica. How are you? I'm going to be honest, I've never been so scared in my life.
Well, you've held up very well. You're so very brave. But there's nothing more to worry about, dear. Here are your husband's results from the scan. There's nothing there. He has no medical history at all. He's one of the few people I've come across in my life as being completely healthy. Well, all but the smoking, of course.
So what caused this to happen?
Well, perhaps it was a traumatic memory that entered his mind. Some people have things such as seizures once, twice, maybe three times, but never have them again. A complete one-off.
So, he's fine?
Absolutely nothing to worry about, dear.
Hey, I got here as fast as I could. How is everything?
There's nothing wrong.
Thank you.
sorry. I didn't know I'd like him. I guess maybe next time I should try and land on carpet, right? Come on, Jess, I'm sorry.
You didn't black out.
What?
You didn't black out, Michael. You died.
I didn't die? That's ridiculous.
You didn't have a pulse. Richard tried to find it, I tried to find it, the medics tried to find it, and it wasn't there because you didn't have one.
Did they declare my death?
No.
Why not?
Because you spoke.
What did I say?
I don't know. Your heart started beating soon after. So all those times that you blacked out, you died?
I don't know. That's impossible, isn't it?
Not before tonight, but doctors are baffled by it. They keep trying to tell me that it was just a seizure. Because it's impossible. It's not supposed to happen to anyone.
Maybe that's all it was.
Don't treat me like I'm an idiot, okay? I know the difference between being alive and being dead. I have never been so scared in my life, Michael. I need some space.
It's Jessica Lang. I can't come to the phone right now. Please leave a message after the beep.
I need to know if you're in on this. Has this whole passing out thing finished?
I think so. Maybe. When is it?
Tomorrow. I got Paul, Sam, Tom, and James, and myself out there. I need one more person.
Can Holly do it?
She's out in the office when I'm out. Come on, man. You know that. It's decent money. Jess doesn't have to know. We don't pick them up. We just drop them off. It's nice and quick.
We could use the money until Jess goes back to work. Okay, I'll do it.
Oh, thank God. You're a lifesaver. Whew. When do you think Jess is gonna come back?
Soon. She said she needed some space. She's probably at her uncle's.
Jessica!
Sorry.
Ready?
I haven't touched a drop.
Then why is it there?
Just testing myself. Resisting the urge. I haven't had a drink in 13 months.
That's great. I'm proud of you. We all are. Just don't go back there.
I didn't really think I would. I swore on Anna's life I would never drink again, but look at me now, on the verge of breaking my daughter's heart. Not now, though.
How's Michael?
I told him I needed space. How cruel can I be?
What do you mean?
He's been having these episodes dealing with death, and I've been falling into a pit of self-loathing and despair.
That's just your way of dealing with things. Everyone deals with things differently. When my granddad died, I finished school and locked myself in my room for about a month.
But Michael's not dead. I'm not dealing with his death. It's something else. I feel responsible.
What? Why?
Because
he was so supportive throughout the pregnancy, and it's all been about me. I shouldn't be asking for space. I think he needs my help.
You're right. He does need your help. He just doesn't need someone that hates herself to be there for him, though.
Yeah. I should talk to him.
Yeah.
Do you want to come?
Yeah, I'll follow behind.
Where do I begin?
You don't have to talk.
No, but I want to. I feel like it's necessary.
I'm the one who should be talking.
Please, Michael. I shouldn't have been the way I was to you. I took this problem that affects both of us and I put it all onto you.
Before you continue, I was thinking about what to do.
What?
I was thinking maybe this whole blackout thing is hereditary. And the only person who would know that is David.
No, please tell me you're not going to go see him.
I may have to. I want to know what it meant.
Does he have the condition? Can it be treated?
When are you going to go?
Today, if possible.
Okay. I'll go with you. Please be careful.
You're his first visitor in 3 years. It's a shame, though. He can't help the way he is.
I'm sure he's been fine.
Oh, sure, we look after him. A man of his nature needs to be looked after almost on an hourly basis.
An hourly basis?
Yeah. Any trouble? We're here.
Hi, David.
Hello.
How have you been?
Fine.
Jessica sends her love.
Tell her thank you.
I should tell you. You're an uncle.
Congratulations. Is that all?
I have to find something out from you.
What?
Lately, I've been experiencing these blackouts. Well, they're not exactly blackouts, it's like I die.
Odd.
Yeah, odd. Have you experienced anything like it? Is it in our genes or something?
No.
No?
That's right.
I just wanted to try and find out, wondered if you were experiencing the same thing, or if it was just me.
It's just you. Can I go now?
No. No, you can't. Did Mom have it? Did Dad?
Sure.
You're not helping me!
Sir, you need to calm down or you'll be removed.
Sorry. I'd like to get some answers.
I don't know the answers to your questions, dear brother. I, like you, am just as confused.
What happened to you?
I've tried jumping the fence a few times.
You tried escaping this place?
Yes. This place. Ready to go.
Getting out of this place seems like breaking into Fort Knox. Did he really try and escape?
He didn't try and escape. He tried taking his own life. He took a handful of syringes and sliced them straight down.
When was this?
Over the past month or so. He never brings harm on others, just for himself.
Okay. Thanks for everything.
Find anything out?
No, nothing at all.
Was he cooperative?
Yeah. He hasn't been having any seizures, but he's been trying to kill himself.
Oh my god.
His arms were covered in cuts. Gotta mean something.
Do you have another headache?
No, I'm just thinking of going back to David.
Why?
He's hiding something, and I have to get it out of him.
You tried today. If he's not going to tell you something today, he's not going to tell you something any other day.
I'll get answers.
I was hoping that we could go see Raymond tomorrow anyway.
You can take Anna. I'll get Rich to give me a ride in.
It's the prom. He's going to be busy.
I'll go before the prom.
Fine, but make sure you ask first before you make an appointment with David.
Capable of putting one foot in front of the other.
I can do that.
Oh yeah?
I can definitely
prove it.
Do that. Watch.
Oh.
Thank you for that.
Not a problem. Is someone here to watch you? Someone to make sure that you won't...
Yeah, I'm good. Actually, my roommate's in there, so...
Right.
Okay.
Well, thank you for a great night.
Well, thanks for not leaving me on my own.
Why would I?
Well, it's not really a secret, but I can't handle my alcohol.
No, I think the whole town knows that by now.
Yeah, maybe.
So I'll call you later?
Yeah, you have my number. There you go. Gonna go see Uncle Ray.
Hey,
sorry, I didn't want to wake you. I'm just taking Anna to Ray's.
I thought you were doing that later.
Yeah, well, I just thought I'd go now so I could take you to the institution later.
Don't worry about that. I thought I said Rich was taking me.
Oh, right, yeah. Sorry. Did you have a good night's sleep?
Yeah, no blackouts or anything.
Good, okay, then maybe it's all stopped.
I think so.
Right, well, if I don't see you before you get back, I'll see you tonight, okay?
Should be back by 6.
Okay. You really dig into his mind, okay?
I will.
I've never had a dream like that before in my life. It was surreal.
Well, you know, it could be your fears about Michael that's playing a part in it.
Maybe. I don't know. It was like a fond memory of mine was invaded by something. Something else.
Listen, you just worried. Everybody worries about things, and death is one of them. You have to realize that it's inevitable, and it's going to come. But then you have to reassure yourself that everything is going to be okay. Michael's condition has been cleared. He hasn't blacked out since he's been out of the hospital, has he?
No.
Well, you see, they saw it, they fixed it, and told you nothing. Because that's all that's left. Nothing. Michael's fine.
The directions to the points are in the glove box. Now when you park, get your asses back here so we can go to the bar, okay?
Not me.
Hold on. Why not?
I'm just taking it easy as all.
Oh, don't tell me you're having second thoughts on this.
I'm not, it's...
Listen, I know your situation all, but come on. You're like the brother I never had.
You have a brother, though.
Yeah, he's an asshole. That's besides the point. Just, do you feel any weirdness at all?
No, I've been fine since the hospital.
Okay, that's good. All right, you're already logged into my channel, so if you're feeling like death...
I got it.
All right. Take care of yourself, man.
I will.
I hope he's getting all he can get.
Is Michael's birth parents still alive?
He doesn't know. I don't think he wants to know who they are.
Well, it's understandable.
Yeah, all I know is they weren't very nice people. But luckily he got passed on to a lovely couple.
You know, it's a shame what happened to David's parents. How old was he?
He was 8. I think that's what sent him on his route of depression. It's what got him where he is now.
Depression did that to him?
Well, no, but it probably didn't help. He tried to take out a few students with a compass. He and David used to write to each other to try to be brothers until the end.
They wrote to each other?
Yeah, they did. But once David got sent to the institution, they just stopped writing. I should probably get going. I want to be there for him when he gets home.
Now remember, if there's anything that you need, you know where to find me.
Of course. I'll see you soon.
I wonder if they'll play our song.
I know, I love One Direction.
Me too.
Yay, prom 2015!
2015!
Woo!
Woo!
Who's ready for prom?
Woo!
All right, let's go.
Night, Anna.
Good afternoon, Mr. Lanham. My name's Dolores Holder, and I'm the receptionist here at the Garrett Lodge Institute. I'm very sorry to have to be the one to tell you, but your brother, Mr. David Banning, was found dead in his room. We'd like for you to come in so we can ask you some questions. I'm sorry to ask, as it's such a tragic time. Thank you for your cooperation.
Hello?
Hello, this is Jessica Langham. I've just heard your message. Thank you. My husband should already be there.
No, sorry, ma'am. We don't have any record of your husband being here today.
That's not right. He might be on his way.
When he gets here, I can definitely let you know if you'd like.
Yes, please. Thank you.
No problem. Bye.
Bye.
First when we get there.
I think that we should drink a ton. I think that's a good idea.
You think somebody spiked the punch this year?
I hope so.
Last year I heard it got crazy.
I hope it's wild this year. I want a night that we are never gonna forget.
I'm dead now, right? The SUV did it. But my time's not up yet. Is he coming? Huh? Is he gonna show his face this time?
He is right here.
David?
I got over the fence today.
What are you talking about?
This place looks familiar. You and I used to come to this field when we were kids. When we were happy.
The scars.
War scars. The war with myself. I tried getting over the fence, but something kept pulling me back. I knew you'd be here, though.
How?
The twinling.
What are you talking about?
This is purgatory. My purgatory. I need your soul to get to the afterlife. Whenever I cut my wrists, a part of you died. That's what brought you here, to wait for me. But something kept pulling us back. I created this place. Every time I tried jumping the fence, I would add a little something to it, whether it be Jessica, or the clock that's digging your grave as we speak. But that long pathway leads to the death for the dead. It's a place I've been longing to go for 22 years. But I need you. I need you to get to it. But there's an invisible rope. It keeps pulling you back. Believe me, Michael. That rope is gonna get cut.
You're gonna have to wait till I'm an old man because I have no plans to drop down now.
You can't do this to me, Michael. We are brothers.
Look, I'm sorry, but I have a wife and a little girl.
What makes you think I can't sit next to Jessica and make her crash her car?
If you go near her...
Come on. What are you gonna do? I'm dead now. You're still alive, but you won't be for long. Look what you did. I put the image here to get you to stay. Make you think she was real. Too much of my bad thoughts went into her.
What?
She had some nice things to say when she slipped into Jessica's dream last night.
What?
She can do it. I can. Goodbye, Michael. I'll see you soon.
No!
Michael?
Jess, turn on the TV, channel 7.
The driver is refusing medical attention and is currently being given a breathalyzer by the police. The parents of the children are on their way to pick them up. It's a sad night for the prom-goers.
It's Michael. Jessica, I'm so sorry. Hello? Jess? Are you still there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Thank you.
You fucking liar! I fucking hate you! You could have died! Don't try and come for me! You fucking prick! I can't believe you! I cannot believe you!
It's okay!
It's not! You're so fucking stupid! Don't touch me! You'll never get to touch me again!
Sorry I lied to you.
Just shut up.
No, I won't.
Shut up!
You're acting crazy.
Right. Okay, I'm the crazy one.
So we're gonna talk about this?
I don't wanna talk to you! You don't consider anyone's feelings except for your own.
Well, I'm sorry.
Oh, your apologies mean nothing to me now.
Oh, I fucked up.
Oh, you did more than fuck up! You have put an enormous strain over this entire house. Trust you anymore.
God damn it, Jess, you can trust me. Fuck, we just sit here and talk.
I shouldn't smoke these.
They'll kill me. You're still mad, aren't you?
No. I'm just past the point of caring. You don't listen to reason. You just listen to what you want to hear. You didn't even go to the institution.
I know.
This is probably not the best time to tell you, but, your brother...
I know. He's dead.
Who told you?
He did.
What do you mean, he did?
I died in the SUV. There's a place that I go when I die. It's the place I described to you with the clock in the field. Well, it turns out that's purgatory. But it's David's purgatory. He's created a place from his memory that's a sort of waiting place until we're together.
What happens when you're together?
That's when I die. He mentioned something about a twin link, an invisible rope that connects the two of us. He can't go on his own. He needs his twin. He needs me. Now he's just a ghost that waits. He wants to go to the other side and not be in between. He's gonna take me out and I don't know when. He's a ghost, how am I supposed to prepare myself for it?
Okay, I have to tell you something.
What?
The other night I had this dream. Except it actually wasn't really a dream, it was like a memory, but it was that work Christmas party when you walked me home.
I remember.
Right, well, something else happened. I became that thing that you told me about. These dead eyes. I killed you.
David said she went into your dream. I tried to attack him, but I went right through him, and when I knocked into her, she vaporized.
Do you think that maybe you could draw this place? This other world.
Uh-huh. See that bit there? You said that beyond that lies death for the dead.
What does that even mean?
Heaven, hell, wherever it is, it's there. He said he can't get onto the path unless I'm with him. I've never heard of any twin link before.
Why don't you talk to Dr. Levenstein again? Would he know?
I'm not getting anyone else involved. This is between us and him.
the fuck, Mike?
What?
I thought you were in the clear.
I thought I was.
Well, let me tell you something. You weren't. You know how I know? The crashed car in my parking lot. Jesus, the parents of the promgoers want to sue us. Sue us.
Rich, I'm sorry. I thought I had it under control.
Yeah, I am too. I gotta suspend your license until the cops are done probing your file.
That's fine. I understand.
And Mike, I thought you were gonna start working for us again. Do you want to go to the offices instead of driving?
I don't know. I guess it'll give you guys a bad rep if I stay there.
Oh, don't start throwing in the towel just yet. Just think it over.
All right, I'll think it over.
Sitting at a desk is far less risky if you're going to black out than if you're behind the wheel of a car.
Stop saying black out. I die.
Because we all like to be reminded of that.
So you're not afraid of death, yet you won't succumb to it. We'll see. Oh, by the way, give this to your wife. I'll succumb to you!
Oh my God, what happened?
I'm fine.
You're not fine! Michael, what? You need something. You. Holy shit. You have a fan.
Who is it?
It's from an anonymous person. They've sent you an email.
What does it say?
Dear Mr. Langham, I saw you on the news the other day and was amazed. I've been diagnosed with cancer for about 4 months now, and I haven't told anybody about it. Doctors say I'm hanging on by a thread and will probably not live through the week. I won't lie to you, I'm terrified of dying. I live in your town and would be grateful if you could come to see me. I hope to hear from you soon. Wow. What should I say back?
What do you think I should do?
I think you should go.
I don't know. I don't have cancer. I can't relate to it. When I die, I just go like a form of narcolepsy. The best I can do is make it up for him.
Why don't you do that then?
Okay. Email them back asking where they live and if they're available today.
Oh, wow. They must have been waiting for it.
What does it say?
It's the address. That doesn't make sense. That's Ray's address.
Jessica, oh my goodness, you've grown into such a beautiful... beautiful, beautiful woman.
I brought Michael like you asked.
Yeah, yes. I did ask for him, didn't I?
I just wanted to come in first to make sure that you're okay.
Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Oh. Michael, tell me what dying is like. Is it like a roller coaster? I used to like to ride those when I was younger. It's been over 20 years since I rode one.
Well, it all happens so fast. The beginning, I guess, is like going up on a roller coaster, but instead of going along the loops, you get...
What? What?
I don't know.
You know, maybe that's what it's supposed to be like, not knowing.
I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry, Michael. You've told me enough already. I'm dying, Michael. And dying is, well, it comes in many ways, shapes and forms. I mean, it could be like a roller coaster, or it could be like falling asleep, or could be the most fulfilling experience you'll ever have. It's it's ironic, isn't it?
What is?
Life's biggest mystery has nothing to do with life at all.
You're right.
What's this?
I need you to do me a favor. When you die, you go to a place and you have to walk towards the light. The place you go is the last piece of memory you have.
Well, what do you mean?
Keep this picture. Memorize it. I need you to stay there and wait for me. Remember it well?
Yes.
Keep thinking about it. I need you to help me.
I'm halfway there already.
Thank you, sir.
Michael? I'll see you soon.
Thank you.
Someone should be there with him. His helper shouldn't have gone home. I might call an ambulance.
You go. Go and stay the night. At least you'll be there if anything happens.
Yeah, okay. You're right. I'll get in and we can all go.
I can't.
Why not?
He's your family. It would mean more if it was just you.
He's your family too.
If we both die, how will you react?
Well, you'll come back.
And what if David does away with me? Just go. I'll be fine.
come and get me. I'm ready for you. Do your worst.
Walk on down there!
Michael, hold on!
Isn't it funny? When we were kids, you were the one to drive a sword through me and leave me to die in this field. I'll show you playing around.
David, it's time to go now.
Michael, come back. Michael. Come back. Michael. Come back.
It's over. He's gone.